Welcome to Now Church. We are about to begin. Please take this opportunity to pull out your smartphone so you can like, share, and check in on our social media platforms, including Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And please use the hashtag NowChurch. Thank you, and enjoy today's service.
How are we doing this morning? Are you ready to worship the Lord with us?
Come on. I'm so glad I get to worship next to you today. Tell them. Tell the person on the other side, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Tell them. This morning, let it rise. Holy Spirit, you're welcome. And every single time we gather, we're mindful of your power and your strength and your ability to change circumstances. And God, even if things in the natural don't necessarily move, you change our perspective. And you give us faith. And you give us hope. So with our hands lifted high, sing it again. Let it rise up. Sing it.
Like a river.
Ask him. Higher than the name of Jesus. Come on, singers, lift your voices if you would. Fill this room with worship. There's no power like your name, Jesus. There's a name that levels mountains and carves out highways through the sea. And I've seen its power unravel battles right in front of me. Am I the only one this morning? Yeah. And there's a faith that stands defiant. Sends Goliath to his knees, yeah. And I've seen his praise unravel shackles right off my feet, yeah. If that's you, sing it real strong with us. That's the power, say, 'cause that's the power. Lift his name out of this building. Lift your name, Jesus. Oh, how great you are. Hallelujah. This morning in this room today, we declare it again. I see you taking ground. I see you taking ground. I see you press ahead. Your power is dangerous to the enemy's camp. This morning say, you still. Strongholds, Jesus. Any believers in the room? Any believers? And that same power can settle your soul and help you find yourself in a place where you just believe that the word of God is true. His promises are yes and amen. And I thank you, God. We set our eyes on you. We set our hope on you. We set our faith in you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You know it, right? Sing your worship now. Next few moments, I wonder if you can close those eyes. and just begin to worship you in this room, all over the building. Our faith is in you, God. Our hope is in the name of Jesus. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Circumstances, and this is a great moment for you to be able to say, I fix my eyes on the God. You say, through every thought, future is secure in our way. I believe you today.
Thank God. Listen, we've got some things to pray for today. And one of the things that has taken place this week, Pastor Lindsay is going to be going to England. And so he's got some great plans there. Pastor Julian and Sharon Melfi are here this morning. And we are so glad to have them here, our guests. He'll be stepping up and sharing the word today. And we're just so grateful for the connection and the relationship that our churches have. back and forth, being able to bless each other. It's awesome. And so they have invited Pastor Lindsay, and they have a time for him to go up there, bless their church, help to pour into their leaders and worship, and it's going to be a powerful time. So we're going to pray for Pastor Lindsay. We say something that's important. We send. We don't just have someone go. We send them. And as we send them, you're a part of it because your faith is helping to launch him to a successful mission, right? So we're excited about that. We're going to pray for him. But we also can't help. We have to. We need to acknowledge what's taking place in the world right now. If you saw the news of what was taking place this weekend, just some crazy stuff that was happening in Israel, Hamas terrorist attacks in Israel. If you don't know, I just looked it up this morning. They said that that first attack of Hamas against Israel killed at least 400 people and wounded over 2,000. And the numbers are still rising, counting as they go. And the best way I heard it described is an Israeli commentator. He said, this is our 9/11. This is our 9/11. So remember how we were on 9/11 when we were attacked by terrorists and it just shook our nation. That is what is taking place. Now, I want to read with you something about this. I want to read to you Psalms 121. This is one of the promises of many that God has given over his people Israel and blessings. So let me just read to you just a little bit of this. Read the whole thing later. But out of Psalms 121, he says, he who watches over Israel neither slumbers or sleeps. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord stands beside you as your protective shade. The sun will not harm you by day, nor will the moon at night. The Lord keeps you from all harm and watches over your life. That is one of many promises that God has spoken over Israel. So I'm just saying all this, not trying to make us political, but I tell you what, you better determine which side you're on because God's very clear about his promises over Israel. Amen? And we as a church, we need to be agreeing and praying for them. So we're going to pray for them as well, too, during this time. Yes, they are at war because they've declared war against Hamas. And so there's a lot of stuff going on in the Middle East. Hey, welcome to End Times, right? But there's great blessing that is happening in this time with all the promises of God that are coming forth. It's an amazing time to be in. Come on, people. Yeah. Amazing time for us to live in. Let's be a church that we find that we're on the right side of what God is promising. Amen? So let's right now pray for Pastor Lindsay. Just stretch your hands towards him. And Father, we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity and the gift that is inside of Pastor Lindsay. And we thank you, Lord, that it blesses us so much. But we thank you that it's about to bless many more people, Lord, in England, our brothers and sisters that are over there in CityGate Church, Lord. We ask you, Lord, that you would send, we send Pastor Lindsay with blessing, with favor, Lord, with abundance in his heart and his soul, Lord, to give and to encourage others. Father, we pray that his gift just speaks to everyone else there and just causes them to just come alive to new levels and their giftedness and their expression and worship. Father, we will send him with blessing and favor. Favor him even as he travels. Every step of the way, we pray that his travel is blessed, Lord, and favored. Everywhere he goes, open doors for him, Lord. And Lord, we just pray for divine connections and a free flow of your spirit through him during this time in Jesus' name. And Father, we agree, Lord, for the nation of Israel, and we stand in your promise and believe that you are a God who defends Israel. Father, we pray for their protection. We pray for their safety. We pray that you would be, Lord, you said there's technology, iron shield, but you said that you would be the shield. Father, we pray that you protect them, bless them, give them wisdom in this time, Lord, to be able, if they're going to war, Lord, let it be with wisdom and not with anger and not with resentment or vengeance, but wisdom from God, wisdom and favor. And Lord, bless the nations, Lord, that stand with Israel. In Jesus' name, we give you praise today. Amen. All right. Amen. Come on. Still. Let's continue in this time. Remember, there was something that happened back in 9/11. We were shocked at the beginning, and then there was almost an addiction to watch what was happening in the news day by day by day by day by day by day. Realize the church, we can't just be in this shock response Yeah, watch the news, but pray. If you're going to see something, pray. If you're going to watch it, pray. You're going to listen, pray. Amen? That's what church does best. Pray. Amen? All right. Going to turn around, look around, find somebody you didn't ride to church with, and welcome them to Now Church, and we'll continue in a minute. All right. So we've got a lot to share with you. So right now we want to share that portion of the service in the know. We always want to make sure that you know what's taking place. Maybe you weren't in these circles of ministry that are always happening at Now Church. And so some of the stuff that happened, of course, this last week, we had our team that went on a mission to D.C., a prayer mission to D.C. So I want to give you guys give it up for the team. Came back just yesterday. And we've got some pictures they're sharing. Oh, I got to hurry because they're just going. Okay, you saw pictures of, the river cruise, seeing some of the monuments. They went and prayed at the Supreme Court. They have a picture of Union Station where they went as well to in a Capitol tour. And then also went to the Washington Monument, Reflection Pool, and Lincoln Memorial. And then ended up at the Pentagon and 9/11 Memorial. All of these places, they were prayer walking. They had declarations that they were believing and praying over our nation. And I tell you what a timely mission to be in D.C. at this time. We found that every time that as we've gone and we've sent a team with Pastor Gail leading this team, it's been right on time. Just right on time. So we're thanking God for a mission. Well done. Awesome. And glad to have you guys back. So good. Yeah. So yeah, let's give it up again for our prayer mission team. Look at them. Awesome. All right. And then this week, there was a great conference in Virginia Beach, and our pastor, senior pastor, Pastor Richard, was up there and taking part and everything, connecting with some people up there. And he was also honored to share the offering encouragement there at Wave Conference. And so we were so glad to see our pastor and see him step up and respond. He shared some of the stuff about our season in building the legacy building, and he said it turned out to be a great encouragement for everybody there. So isn't that cool that he's being able to go and bless and just extend this blessing that we're seeing in the church? Is awesome. So how many are proud of your pastors? Aren't they awesome? Come on, that's pretty cool. In D.C. and Virginia Beach and representing, that's pretty awesome. So listen, if you are newer to Now Church, we always want to make sure that you feel welcome. And the best way to first connect is at our Guest Experience Center. And you'll see that as you go out through the Legacy Building. You'll be facing it right before you exit. There's a nice counter there. And we have some gifts for you just to bless you and thank you for coming. And as always, we challenge you from your very first experience of Now Church. It's called a three-week challenge. Check out Now Church. 3 weeks in a row and see what God does. Yes, see what God does, because we're expecting that if you give God just a little margin, a little room in your life, give him 3 weeks. Sometimes it takes a little bit to get through to you. Yes, it does. So give him 3 weeks and see how he works and starts moving in your life. And we know God will start showing up strong. All right. Okay. So I want to introduce our pastor, senior pastor. He's going to be introducing our guests.
Thank you so much. You can bring that up, Danny. We're so glad that you're here today. It's exciting to be together. It is the one of the holiest of days in the Florida calendar, the day when the first cold front comes in. So we want to praise God for 58 degrees this morning, 56 tomorrow morning, and 54 Tuesday morning. Woo! And then 90 degrees again on Friday. Anyway, we're just really excited to have our guests with us today. Pastors Julian and Sharon are with us. They were with me in Virginia Beach. We had a couple hundred pastors from all over the world that were there. And it was, for the evening meetings, there were a couple of thousand people. It was a great, great time, and we were really glad to be part of it. And it was very encouraging to be up there and to get fed and get blessing and prayed for. Pastor Julian Melfi has been my friend, along with his wife Sharon, for over 25 years now. We met in Folkestone, England, many years ago. He invited me to come to London and do a conference, and I was really excited to come to a conference. At that point, I didn't realize his church was 20 people. But this man has always been filled with faith and power. He had, listen to this, he had me preach 19 sessions to 20 people. Actually, 40 people showed up. There were 20 members. It was like 40 people, 50 people showed up. And we've been friends ever since. I said, that guy has the guts enough to do that for 20 people and do 19 one-hour sessions. He has my respect. They have since gone on to build CityGate Church. They bought an old post office years ago and converted it to a church. And it's a miracle. You can't find real estate in London, England. They don't make any more land, okay? So you can't find. They've done this. The church now is hundreds or thousands. It is a tremendous church, very diverse. And I'm always excited to be there. I'd like you to get up on your feet and give a great Now Church welcome to Pastor Julian Melfi as he comes.
So good to be here. Fantastic. So good to be back. Really, really good. Why don't you turn to somebody and tell them they're looking absolutely awesome this morning, yeah? Tell them they're looking younger than when they came in, like half an hour ago. You may take your seats. It is so good to be back in Ocala, Florida, and to be with, I know you've already said some stuff, but yeah, we've been friends for 25 years, just over. And it's a real important friendship for Sharon and I. How many of you know God puts heart to heart? Yeah, he puts hearts together. And that's because those are to strengthen churches and strengthen relationships, and I believe even to strengthen cities and nations. And, you know, God has got his people all over the earth. And everywhere you go, you find someone praising Jesus Christ. And this place is full of faith this morning and full of praise. And it's so good to be here. And we love coming here. And all my boys have been here over the years. And they send their love, actually. One is now 28 years old and married. Where does the time fly? And you know what? 28 years ago, in fact, 30 years ago, 35 years ago, they said we'd never have children. That was the doctor's announcement. We would never have children. Well, we proved them wrong by the word of God three times. Sharon conceived, and the first time she was 4 months pregnant and we didn't know. So absolutely amazing. Come on, guys, get excited about this is amazing. So don't tell me God is not able to do the impossible, because we've seen it three times now and in so many ways. And today's a really important day. It's my 39th year of being a believer today, 8th of October. The 8th of October, 1984, I gave my life to Christ. So this is a real good day for me. Wow, exciting stuff, 38 years. And at that time, I was a punk on drugs, orange hair, makeup, chains, safety pins. That was my teenage years. And I turned up at a service. I was a church hater. Just did not want to be around Christians or churches or any of that. I thought that, let's not go where I thought what they were. So anyway, I turned up at a service, and an hour later I gave my life to Christ. And he invaded my life by the power of his spirit, turned my life upside down, cleaned out all the old, put in his spirit, and I was what the word of God says, born again. I had a brand new start in life. The old has gone, a new creation. I didn't just clean myself up a little bit and become religious. I was recreated on the inside. God did what only God can do. And I get excited about that. Then I met this wonderful lady here from Cornwall. And that's like a part of England where you go if you want to see sheep and cows and goats. And go on a holiday over there. And it's all grass and fields. In fact, she had horses in her back garden. Her backyard. You call it a yard. Is that right? Yard. And so you have to forgive me. I'm English. So we don't have yards. We have gardens. And they do the same job. But anyway, so we've been married now 36 years last Tuesday. So that's amazing. It's all happening this week. There you go. Amazing. I'd like you to turn in your Bibles if you have them. And I love my Bible. It's you know, we're stirring something up back in CityGate, you know, to get hold of real Bibles again. Not from a, you know, traditional point of view, but sometimes, you know, especially to the mums and dads in the place, if you're on your phone and you're on your Bible, your kids don't know whether you're on Facebook or reading your Bible. And I think we need to make a statement in this day that says our kids can see when we're reading the Word of God. And I'm not putting that into this church, but I know for our families back in the UK, they're saying, yeah, we need to do this so our kids can see when we're reading the Bible and not just on Facebook. Because they don't know what we're on. And so, you know, there's something about this book, isn't there? There's something about God's word. We've been singing it earlier. I love that song. We hadn't heard that, you know, before the conference this week about, you know, God said it or he's, well, I can't remember the words now. I filmed it anyway because I like it. We're in the middle of a series back in CityGate, which Pastor Lindsay's going to be at next week. I can't wait. We're going to have a blast and we're doing a series called God Said It, I Believe It, That Settles It. So that word will go, you know, that song will fit right into that. Well, we're going to turn to the Bible today, and I've got something on my heart. I've done a series earlier this year from a book that I'd never done a series on, and in really asking God, what should I bring here today, I really felt to go back to that book, and it's the book of, it's an Old Testament book, it's the book of Daniel, and it's obviously quite a powerful book. It's a book that we'd know about the fiery furnace. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fiery furnace. We know of Daniel in the lion's den. We know of the golden images. We know of all the end time stuff going on in there. So I'm not going to do any of that this morning. But I do want to turn to just three passages. The first passage is in the first chapter. And I'm just going to cut in. I think we've got these coming up on the screen here. Just a couple of verses from verse 18. It says, then the king interviewed them, and among them all, none was found like Daniel and then Shadrach and these other team. Therefore, they served before the king. And in all matters of understanding about the king examined them, he found them 10 times better. Everybody say 10 times better. Look at someone, say 10 times better. I want this to sink into our hearts this morning. These guys were 10 times better than anybody else the king could find. 10 times than all the magicians, the astrologers who were in all the realm. Now in chapter 5 from verse 11 and 12, there is a man in your kingdom. This is a, you know, astrologer speaking to the king at that time. There is a man in your kingdom, king, in whom is the spirit of the Holy God. What an amazing testimony to have. What an incredible thing to say. In Acts chapter 5, we know the church looked for people who were full of the Holy Spirit and full of faith. But here you have somebody, an astrologer, somebody in the enemy's camp speaking to the king, and he's telling the story of these guys, Daniel, and he said, there's a man in whom what he's known for in his life is the spirit of the Holy God. I mean, these guys are in the enemy's camp. These guys are into the occult, soothsaying, seances, whatever else, stargazing. And yet they said there's something so different about this man. In whom is the spirit of the Holy God, and in the days of your father, light and understanding, like the understanding of the gods were found in him. And King Nebuchadnezzar, your father the king, made him chief of the magicians, the astrologers, Chaldeans, the soothsayers, inasmuch as an excellent spirit, knowledge, understanding, interpreting dreams, solving problems, explaining enigmas were found in this guy Daniel. Now let Daniel be called. He's going to sort out your problem. He'll give the interpretation. And finally, Daniel chapter 6, verses 1 to 3. And it pleased Darius to set over the kingdom 120 satraps, to be over the whole kingdom. And over these three were three governors, of whom this guy, Daniel, was one, that the satraps might give account to them, and the king would suffer no loss. Then this guy, Daniel, he distinguished himself above the governors and the satraps. Why? Because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king gave thought to set him in, for putting him over the whole realm. Today I want to speak on an excellent spirit. An excellent spirit. Now, I don't know about you. I've been around church a long time. I've been pastoring now with Sharon for 32 years. We've been Christians. Well, Sharon has, you know, since she was 5, 6, 7 years old. And I gave my life to Christ when I was 18, 39 years ago today. And I've heard that expression, an excellent spirit, so many times. I've preached on it many times. I've spoken to my leaders, my praise team, about having an excellent spirit. And of course, we can understand that about doing things well. Yes. Having great facilities. And can I just say, this new building that you've just built, a milestone in the life of Now Church. It's absolutely awesome. I know we talked last night. I had the grand tour last night when none of you were here. So I got the VIP tour with Sharon, and we went into the ladies and to the men's. I couldn't have done that if anyone was here. We went everywhere. We looked in the storerooms. We looked in the restrooms. We looked in the just everywhere, the kids' facilities that are just coming. Absolutely amazing. And you said to me, this has been 17 years coming. 17 years. I remember when you were over in one of those amazing conferences we did, when you did like 20 sessions. And you were, you know, do I or don't I build the dome? And do we do this? Do we do that? Thank God for a pastor who's led by the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. Come on, you got to appreciate Richard and Gail here, who are led by the Holy Ghost, people of faith who build something exceptional. And there is no doubt there is an excellence about everything they do, everything they believe for. This church has got excellence through and through. I come here, I've been, you know, taking photographs of things on the ceiling, things on the platform. I love on the bass guitar, you got a little GoPro. Come on. We haven't got one on our bass guitar, but when I get home, I'm going to make sure we get one on our bass guitar. It's just great. You got them stuck here, you got screens, you got that round LED screen in your lobby over there. You know, I was told, you know, to come today and come about 8:30, 9:30. So we came and we walked through the facilities, and all the guests, you know, team and Pastor Richard said, we thought you were coming round the back. We've been looking at your, you know, trying to find your car around the back. And I said, I just wanted to walk through the facilities again. Because it's so good to advance and to have that excellence about everything that you do. The seats that you sit on, even the coffee that you drink. Let's do the best. If it needs to be done, the church should be doing it, and should be doing it best. Should be doing it best. Our building now is getting a little bit tired. We've been in it for 20 years, and you know, you go in the restrooms, and the, you know, the grout in between the tiles is not the best, and it's not looking where it, you know, should be. So I want you to use our, you know, to agree with us and use your faith, because you got a building going on right now. We're just about, we've offered on a building. The offer's been agreed, accepted, and we've got 5 weeks, which is incredible in the United Kingdom. It normally takes 3 to 6 months. We've got 5 weeks to complete the purchase on a theater in our area, which would give us a 1,200-seater auditorium. It was built as a 2,000-seater. So I want you to put your faith with us, because we need some miracles right now. We're doing everything we can. Let's see what God can do, whatever that was. So we believe in a spirit of excellence that's been set over us, you know, so many times over the years. But as I go to these three areas here, these three scriptures that we've just read, it seems to indicate that there's a little bit of a different understanding here about a spirit of excellence. What a spirit of excellence is, and I just want to just say just some things this morning just to provoke and stir up something for us to go further. Is that okay? It means an extraordinary spirit. An extraordinary spirit, a special spirit, an overflowing spirit, an overabundance of spirit. Often we think about an excellent spirit is in something that you see, something that you have, that something is done really well. But I want to say, you know, perhaps go one step, you know, before that, that an excellent spirit is not something that you do, it's something that you are on the inside. And I want to speak right into your heart this morning, and I want to say, come on guys, let's have an excellent spirit, which starts with having a testimony of being known, of being filled with the Spirit of the Holy God. It's the Holy Ghost on the inside, which does something completely different on the inside of the church than you will ever see in the world. The world cannot have an excellent spirit. Now, I'm amazed by what I see over in, you know, the dome thing they've just built over in, where is it? Las Vegas. This dome thing that's cost, I don't know how much, but can I just say, it does not have a spirit of excellence. It may be brilliant and it's phenomenal and I want to go and see it. I want to hear the sound. But there's no spirit of excellence in it if it's not filled with the Holy Ghost, because the Holy Ghost is the excellent spirit. And an excellent spirit is not just how well you do something, because the world can do stuff well. But an excellent spirit is being filled with the Holy Spirit and hearing His voice and being led by the Holy Spirit. I just want to go through, I've got about half a dozen things here and I probably won't have time to get through them all. But the first thing is an excellent spirit is a preeminent spirit. A preeminent spirit. What do I understand by that? Well, it comes from a couple of English words and it means to be a predominant spirit. It leads, it stands out, it projects beyond the norm. It goes further than everybody else goes. It is predominant. It's the first thing that you see and you experience, a predominant spirit, but you also put that word with an eminence, and that means elevated. This excellent spirit will rise above its surroundings. It's predominant. It has a place of eminence. You cannot keep an excellent spirit down. It will always rise up. It will always come to the front. It's eminent. It is predominant. It's not just I have an excellent spirit, here's my car. It's not I have an excellent spirit, here's my house, how clean it is. It's about a lifestyle that you cannot keep down. It will always rise up and go further, no matter what is going on around it, because it's a spirit of excellence, predominance, eminence on the inside. An excellent spirit will rise above its flesh. I love that song that we sang. Apparently, it's one of your, about having your soul anchored in God's love. And we must be people whose hearts, whose souls, whose flesh is anchored into the excellence of the Holy Spirit. Anchored into the excellence. Anchored into that Spirit of the Holy God. An excellent spirit, as we found out in this passage, he says, this guy, he excels, he's 10 times better than anybody else, what in areas of wisdom, understanding, insight. It wasn't about the things they had, it's about the quality of life they lived. It's about how much they understood. we've declared this year to be for CityGate Church a year of 10 times greater. At the end of my text, I put a little 10 times G. 10 times greater. And that doesn't mean to say by the end of the year, we'll go from 800 people to 8,000 people. That's not what it means. It's about saying in our areas of understanding and hearing the voice of God and being led by His Spirit, this is going to be an exceptional year. Where we rise above and where we go further and where we're led more than we've ever been led before. Now that will always, you know, create a change in our circumstances. But it's about having that eminence on the inside. Another understanding for an excellent spirit is a spirit that will untie knots. Wow. I know some people and everywhere they go, they tie you up in knots. I don't know if that's an expression over here, but they sort of tie you up. Everything they say, and you know, perhaps you're in their environment or in their workplace or whatever, and you just feel like there's more problems. But an excellent spirit, a person with an excellent spirit, is someone who can solve problems. That was his testimony, Daniel. They said, there's somebody who can come and sort this problem out. What are you known for in your workplace? The one that creates drama? The one that creates issues? You know, you just leave a trail of destruction behind you? Destruction in relationships or in the atmosphere? Or are you somebody that when you walk in, that excellent spirit walks in on the inside of you and things seem to get solved? Problems get solved. Questions get answered. I've got a friend who used to, well, he began in a bank. And he was just like an odd job person in a bank. And he had to do some filing and he had to sort things out. He was a school leaver. And he did this for a long time, you know, 6 months, a year or whatever. And then he went to his boss and he said, listen, all this filing I'm doing, I think I can do this a better way. This is odd job man speaking to big boss. And he said, I think I can do this a better way. Do you mind if I sort of change things around a little bit? And the boss said, sure, help yourself. So he changed things around a little bit, completely changed the operation of that bank from just in the stock room, in the storeroom, in the filing room. And it was only a handful of years later that he led the place and he had a team of 50 people working for him. Why? Because he walked in and he untied some knots. He solved some problems. You know, there's a lot of problems to be solved in our society today. There's a lot of confusion. There's a lot of chaos. I'm not going to start to specify what's going on in the UK right now, but it's nuts. It's crazy. But the church is the place where we can untie some knots. Can I hear an amen this morning? Well, what else is an excellent spirit? Are you getting anything out of this morning? I just want to encourage you to be a people of excellence on the inside. An excellent spirit is a faithful person. A faithful person. Of course, faithful to God and to the kingdom, but really in this for the long haul. I'm so impressed with Daniel. He was taken into captivity as a teenager. And 70 years later, he was still faithful. 70 years of captivity from being a teenager. Now, he went in as a teenager and they tried to, you know, take out all of his belief and put in all their belief. Said, you got to read this and you got to read that and you got to talk like this and you got to talk like that. But as a teenager, he decided on the inside for, you know, however this happened, it was that spirit of excellence on the inside of him that said, you know what? I'm just going to be faithful. I'm going to be faithful. He went through five kings, well, four and a leader, but we'll call them five kings. He went through five different regimes, as it were. He went through 70 years of being held captive. And yet everywhere he went, he was faithful to God. He was faithful to the vision. He was faithful to what he knew to do. And bearing in mind, he couldn't go to church. He couldn't go to the synagogue. He couldn't go to the temple. He was in captivity. He led the team that was the occult crowd. So he had to stand by himself. He had to be faithful on the inside without perhaps other people around him being faithful. Now, he did have Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, but I mean, there was some, that was that excellent spirit on the inside of him. See, so many of us are faithful when we're encouraged to be faithful. So many of us are, you know, faithful when we're in an environment that will cause us to rise. But he was in an adverse environment and yet he remained faithful. Now, I'm believing God that the church is going to grow and, you know, in the times we live in, end times, if you like, you know, and God's glory is getting stronger and the harvest is coming in and the church is rising up and Goliaths are being slayed and mountains are being moved and valleys are being raised up and the kingdom of God is forcefully advancing. But even if it doesn't, I want to be faithful. I want to be a faithful man, faithful to my wife, faithful to my family, faithful to my church, no matter what is going on around me. Because an excellent spirit, a preeminent spirit, is a faithful spirit. Can I hear an amen this morning? What else is an excellent spirit? Wow, I love this. An excellent spirit remembers. An excellent spirit remembers. You know, Daniel could have so easily forgotten about God because they tried to hammer it out of him. He couldn't go to the temple. Nobody was preaching to him. He wasn't allowed to have scriptures. I mean, I'm sure he got them, but all of that was removed from him when he went into captivity. And yet he remembered God. Remember is such a powerful word in the Bible. God remembers. And we are to remember. Forget not all of the benefits of God. So easy to forget when you're going through a storm. He was in a storm of storms and yet he chose daily to remember the God of his fathers. He remembered the power of God. He remembered what God would do. There was that incredible time when he read in the prophets where it said you'll be in captivity for 70 years and then you'll come out. You know, he stirred all that stuff up. He remembered it on the inside. What else about an excellent spirit? An excellent spirit will prosper. I believe in prosperity and I do not apologize for it. I believe it's one of the most powerful words in the Bible. It's actually in the Old Testament, the word shalom. And we know the word shalom and we speak shalom and we declare shalom and we understand it so often as there being God's presence come in and bringing his peace. But it's so much more than peace. Shh, peace, still peace. It means wholeness in every area of your life. And God is a God of shalom. And Daniel, even in captivity, laid hold of the shalom, the peace, the prosperity of God. There are so many great scriptures in the whole of that book about him prospering. Over in Daniel chapter 6, verse 28, it says, "Now Daniel prospered all the days of Darius and Cyrus in captivity." Our prosperity is not dependent on the economy of the nation. Our prosperity is not dependent on the politics of the nation. Come on, some of us think, and I'm not going left or right this morning, but we live in such a polarized society now where people are getting to the place where they hate each other. Thank God the church is a place where everybody can get together on the agreement of God's word and his kingdom, and we come together as the body of Christ, whether they're left or right. But right in the middle of all of that, it doesn't matter who's in politics, if you're in the kingdom, hallelujah, that we have the prosperity and the shalom of Almighty God. And an excellent spirit will always cause you to walk into the place of prosperity. You see, where's your faith this morning? I challenge myself with this. Is it dependent on who's in the White House? Is it dependent on who's in the banking system? Or is it dependent on who's on the throne? Hallelujah. And his name is Jesus Christ, and he's the God of prosperity. Amen. You see, if you have an excellent spirit, it means you're 10 times greater in areas of wisdom and understanding. You'll know what to do with your money. You'll know where to put it, how to give it, how to save it. An excellent spirit is a spirit that knows what to do. It's not confused. It's clear. It has understanding. And of course, when we have the understanding of Almighty God, we can walk into that place of abundance, because that is where he will lead us. What else about an excellent spirit? Well, an excellent spirit is distinguished. Do you remember that verse? We read it. And in all things, Daniel distinguished, not extinguished, distinguished himself. He distinguished himself. Can we put it in our everyday language? He was successful. An excellent spirit will cause you to be successful in all things. That goes with the next one. An excellent spirit is favored. Oh, don't we love the favor of God? Wow, I don't know what I would do if I didn't live with the favor of God upon my life. I heard back in 1991 somebody speak on the favor of God, and it changed my life forever. I can remember it was a conference I was in, and somebody spoke on the favor of God. And I can remember that day I made a decision. I'm going to use my faith to believe God for the favor. That I'm in the right place at the right time. That I'm having conversations with the right people. There are no coincidences. There is only the plan of God. Amen. And as we have an excellent spirit, it means we're led by his spirit, because an excellent spirit is a spirit of wisdom and insight, which means I'm going to be in the right place at the right time. And God's going to open doors for me that no one can shut. An excellent spirit is a favored life. All the days of Daniel, he was favored. He was favored with the guards. He was favored when he said, I'm not going to eat the food offered to idols. He could have been put to death for that. But you know what? The guard favored him. He was favored with the rulers. He was favored throughout 70 years. The open hand of God upon our lives is as a result of the excellent spirit of God. Supernatural provision, supernatural favor in times of hardship and famine. An excellent spirit is a promoted life. A promoted life. You know, I just want to speak right into your situation and say, God's got more for you. He wants to take you further. He wants to promote your life, not to reduce your life. And all of this comes hand in hand with that excellent spirit. You know, the one big thing today, every sermon has one big thing, and it is this: God, I want to be filled with and walk in and keep in step with the excellent spirit of the Holy Ghost. Every part of my life. The excellence of God on the inside. Whether I have great stuff, well, that's going to follow my life. That excellent spirit on the inside, and an excellent spirit will always bring promotion. In Daniel chapter 2, it says this, verse 48, then the king promoted Daniel and gave him many great gifts. He made him head over the whole province. An excellent spirit is a promoted spirit. Even the next king, the king gave command, and they clothed Daniel in purple and put a chain of gold around his neck. And they made a proclamation concerning him that he should be the third ruler of the kingdom. I believe the church needs to be promoted in our day. I don't know what's happening over here in this part of the world, but I know in England, they're trying to silence the voice of the church. They're trying to silence the voice. You know, they're trying to say, you can't say this, you can't do that. We've just had somebody on the streets who was just praying in her head, arrested for silent prayer. Now it went to court and she was set free. And there's a whole story behind that. But just at the very heart of it, she was arrested for silent prayer. She wasn't protesting. She wasn't campaigning. She was just up against the wall, just standing there praying in her head. And that became a hate crime. I believe we need this excellent spirit to cause the church to be promoted in our day, so we're influencing like we've never influenced before. An excellent spirit does not compromise. Does not compromise. So much pressure on the church today to go to Egypt, as it were, to go the wrong way. Do you remember God said to Isaac, don't go down to Egypt. Stay in the land that God's called you to be in. Stay where God's called you to be. Stay believing what you believe. Stay declaring what you declare. I love the fact that this is a praying church. I know it's always been in your DNA. It's always been in the very heart of who Now Church is, as a church that you declare and you proclaim and you pray and you prophesy and you believe God and you take God at his word. And can I say, come on, let that excellent spirit never be put down. Let it rise up, and let Now Church never be a church of compromise, but always be a church that stands on the written word of God and stands on the declared word of God from the written word of God, that there is no compromise in this place. You know, our flesh and the world's influence wants to try to shut up our quality decisions. But come on, guys, an excellent spirit is a spirit of no compromise. Even if you do go into a lion's den, God will shut the mouths of the lions. But you know what? No compromise in Jesus' name. No compromise. And finally today, as I close, and an excellent spirit will always take God at his word as final authority. I don't care what anyone says. If God said it, that settles it. I believe it. That settles it. An excellent spirit stands on the word of God. You see, they said of Daniel, there's someone in your kingdom. Your dad knew about him. And his lifestyle was he was known to be filled with the Spirit of the Holy God. Amen. I want to encourage you today. You know, we're a church that, you know, believes in the Holy Ghost. And so often, and, you know, correctly so, we think about the gifts of the Spirit, the attributes of the Spirit, the character of the Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit. Dear God, I don't want to walk a step without the Holy Ghost. To keep in step, to hear his voice. But perhaps I want to add into that this morning, that he is a spirit of excellence. A spirit of excellence. And let's put our faith into that attribute of the Holy Ghost. Spirit of God, will you fill me again? Because I want to be a person of excellence on the inside. Can we all stand to our feet this morning and make this our prayer? Is that okay? Spirit of excellence. Come on, if you know how to pray in the Holy Ghost, I don't know, perhaps lift your hands in this room right now. And again, come on, let's pray a little bit here today. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Spirit of God. Can we turn this into a prayer meeting for just 30 seconds? Is that okay? Come on, let's set our minds on the things of the Spirit and not on the things of the flesh here today. Spirit of God, we honor you here. We bless you. Come on, let's dig deep a little bit. Lord, we thank you for your word this morning, then. Holy Spirit, you've shown us from your word that you are the excellent Spirit. Spirit of excellence. the Spirit of the Holy God. And you reside on the inside of the believer. And Holy Spirit, we open our hearts to you again today and say, will you fill us afresh? And in that, Lord, we know that's your character and your power and your ability. But Lord, today we say, will you fill us with that excellence that is only found in the person of the Holy Spirit? Father, we thank you for a church here in Now Church, 10 times greater, 10 times better. Wisdom and understanding, being able to solve problems in Ocala. Lord, being able to solve issues, untie knots in our community. Being able to solve issues of hatred and division and lust, or all the things of the flesh that seem to be out, just being poured out in our generation. Lord, let there be found here in Now Church an excellent spirit of the Holy God. So, Father, we believe and we receive. Lord, perhaps something even today, which is, Lord, something new, to cause us to arise like never before and shine and to be everything you've called us to be. Lord, we take encouragement from Daniel. Lord, just being filled with that excellent spirit, he lasted for a generation. He led for a generation. He prospered for a generation. He shone for a generation. And at the end of it, he led your people out again through his excellent prayer. So, Father, we believe it and we receive it in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Come on, if you believe that, why don't we celebrate a little bit here today? Wow. And you know, we've been speaking about excellent spirit being the person of the Holy Spirit. I said at the very start, today's a very special day for me. And October the 8th, 1984, I gave my life to Christ. He rescued me. He recreated me on the inside. I didn't become religious. I didn't try to be a better person. I didn't turn over a new leaf. I was lost, and he found me. I was dead in sin, and he recreated me the righteousness of God, which means right standing with God, no barrier. And he did that for me. He did that for Sharon when she was 6, 7 years old. As a child in her room, she really knew that God loved her, and she had a picture of Jesus on the cross, and she gave her life to Christ. Friend, I want to ask you today, have you ever received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? You may be here today because you've been brought here by your husband, your wife, your spouse, your boyfriend, your girlfriend. You've been brought up in church. You had no choice. Perhaps you're a little bit intrigued at the moment. What is this God all about? What is Christianity all about? You hear in the world all the time now in the UK, oh, that's just your truth. No, Jesus is the way. He is the truth. He is the life. There's no ambiguity in our God. When you encounter Jesus, you find the truth. I want to ask you today, friend, do you know that you're born again? Do you know, and that's the word the Bible uses, do you know that you're a brand new person in Christ? Sadly, just a couple of Sundays ago in church, we had a 34-year-old. He wasn't in the service. He'd gone to hospital. He had sepsis, and then they found, when they were trying to, you know, treat the sepsis, they found that everything they did didn't work. And they did a blood test on him as he was really in a very bad state. They found he had leukemia. And he died within an hour or so. 34 years old. But you know what? Just 6 months ago, we baptized that man. We baptized him in the pool, and he'd given his life to Christ. And we baptized him in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And so today, as tragic as it's been over the last couple of weeks with somebody, a part of our family, not physical, you know, the church family, going to be with Jesus. We know today he's celebrating in the presence of God. Death has no sting. The Bible says death has been swallowed up. Swallowed up. Friend, do you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Do you know that you'll be going straight to the presence of God in heaven because you've received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? You know, perhaps you're here today and you've never received Jesus Christ as Lord. Or perhaps you're here today and you're saying, you know what? I say I'm a Christian, but I don't live like one. I don't really ever open the Bible. I don't really pray. I don't really have a relationship with God. I call myself a Christian. I come to church, but you know what? I need to commit my life again. I need to say, Jesus, I want to be on fire for you. You know, with every eye closed in this place right now, every head bowed, we're going to just have a time of response right now. If you're here and, you know, perhaps you're here and you need to receive Jesus for the very first time as your Lord and Savior and go through what I went through when I was 19 years old, be born again, a brand new start in your life. Old goes, new comes, God comes into your life. Or perhaps you're here today and you say, you know what, Pastor Jay, I need to stand up. I need to live from that excellent spirit of no compromise. I need to give my life to God again and say from this day forward, everything's going to change in my life. If that's you, with every eye closed and every head bowed, either of those two groups of people, I'm going to ask you to just respond right now. We're all going to pray, just a prayer, but come on. I believe in the power of a response by faith. And if that's you here today, why don't you lift your hand in this auditorium right now, please? Wonderful. God bless you. Wonderful. Come on, are there other people here today? You know you need to give your life to God again or for the first time. God bless you. Wonderful. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. Wonderful. People responding here today. Come on, God's going to do a work by His Spirit in your life. Don't leave this place without knowing that you know that you're a believer in, or that you've come back to God again in a significant way. Is there anybody else here today? Finally, as I look across, let's all pray this prayer together, shall we, and encourage those who have responded. Say, Heavenly Father, thank you that you love me. You've shown me your love by sending your son Jesus to die on the cross to give me life. Thank you, Jesus. I receive you today as my Lord, my Savior, and my friend. I turn away from the way I've lived apart from you. And by the help of your grace and your power, I'll never be the same again. I receive eternal life in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. I'm going to hand over to Pastor Richard. He'll lead you in this.
Thank you. Go ahead and take your seats real quick. Oh, what a great message, what a great thought, great word today. You know, I've just been hearing that the last couple of weeks we've had several children born again in the children's ministry, several. And they came to Pastor Tristan last week and asked when they can be baptized. The little kids asking when they can be baptized in water. And so we have some kind of, Pastor Chris will tell you more about it in a couple of minutes, but that's a sign. To me, that's one of the greatest things, when people are hungry for God and leaning into God. And even, the Bible says, even a little child shall lead them. When kids are starting to get it, and it's getting from here to here, that's a miracle. That's the presence of God. Amen. Amen. Ushers, would you stand up? We're going to give out offering envelopes and I gave cards if you give electronically, which many people do now. If you need something right now, you want to participate in the offering coming just a moment. This is a moment for our tithes and offerings. We're going to sow into this message today. We're going to sow into this word and we're going to believe God for a mighty, mighty harvest. Listen, if you want an excellent spirit, then listen, faith isn't just hearing something. Faith is responding. Faith is an action. And so what happens is sometimes we hear a message, we go, amen. Or actually, y'all were kind of quiet today for first service. I was wondering why you weren't shouting them down a little bit more. Come on, wake up, be who God called you to be. See, here's the thing. The first day where it's cooler weather, the air doesn't turn on as much, so you're a little warmer. So some of you were... That's okay. Wake yourself up right now. This is time we participate here. We don't just watch. We're not spectators. We're participators, and we're trusting God. So the Bible says that when you hear a word, Galatians 6 says, let him who hears a word share with those who teach them. Let them share with the teacher. Respond to a teaching by sowing a seed in faith and believing God. Do you want an excellent spirit in your life? Then don't just say amen today or walk out and go, oh, that was a nice message. No, no. This was God trying to speak something into your heart that's going to be important for your week this week and your life in this next few weeks. God is doing something great, but let's frame that word by putting an exclamation point on it in our faith. I did something over in the front row on my phone. I was able to do it now. Text to give, even though our tithes and offerings are regularly coming out every week automatically, but we still want to sow when the word is hot. Jesus would come in sometimes, and there was a place where they said, if the water is stirred in the fountain, the first one in gets the miracle. Sometimes we want something after church when there's no stirring. Let's respond when the water is being stirred right now. Let's respond with what God is saying and doing. Let's pray right now. Let me pray for you. Father, we thank you for abundant life. Thank you for that word, prosperity. That it's a Bible word, and that we're not afraid of the excess just because we're looking for success. We trust in you with all of our hearts. Would you pour out your spirit upon everyone connected with Now Church, every family member, every person watching online on our online campus today? Would you move, Holy Spirit, move heaven and earth this week to promote those with an excellent spirit with no delay? And we ask you to bless every gift and every giver. In Jesus' name, and we give you praise. Amen. Go ahead and sow right now in faith. Thank you for your generous heart.
All right, as you're giving and the ushers are helping you, we have a few announcements we want to make sure that you're tuned into. First is Liftoff. Liftoff is a class that we have. If you're newer to Now Church, we've got a lot of people that are coming in asking how to be involved, how to hear more about the vision, more particulars. We're going to have this Liftoff class coming next Sunday during second service. We'll be over in the Legacy Building, and you'll be the first class to be in the Legacy Building for Liftoff. How cool? You get a chance to help us to break it in. It's going to be fantastic. And then Now Youth, you have a special event coming up called You Choose. It's a special interactive night that is going to be You Choose what they do, what they talk about, what they eat, what they're doing that evening. It's all up to you. It's going to be pretty cool. That's going to be Sunday the 15th, next Sunday at 6 o'clock. And as Pastor Richard said, we've had a lot of children lately, especially, that have just started really serving God strong. And this is awesome. So it's a fresh new work. So parents have asked us questions about water baptism. We're having water baptisms for adults and kids and youth. Parents, you can sign up your kids. Use this same registration right here, and we'll be getting in touch with you. The next water baptism is going to take place on Sunday the 22nd, right after second service, right between the buildings. It's going to be a great time. And then last, men, MVP, our group of men. We're gathering together for a great dinner and to share some vision about some outreach we're planning to do as men being able to bless our community. And so this is coming up Sunday the 22nd at 5 p.m. We will be meeting at the District Bar and Grill, but we'll be using the kitchen grill side. Just making sure you understand what's happening. Anyway, so their church started in Green Man Pub. Good things happen in pubs, especially if it turns to churches. Yeah. Okay, well, you're going to take this totally out of context. But we're going to be there at this restaurant downtown. Please RSVP to an email if you got that invitation. If you didn't get it, come see me, and we'll make sure you're there. It's going to be a great time. All right, stand up. Stand up. Give somebody a high five next to you. Let's worship God as we go out.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us at Now Church. For the latest updates, visit us at nowchurch.com, including live or on-demand video, event registration, online giving, and much more. And don't forget to follow Now Church on our social media platforms, including Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And please use the hashtag #NowChurch. Thank you.